The fourth session of the 26th legislature will start on March 7th. And after months of planning, government officials are starting to talk about what plans are in store for the province moving into the rest of this year.
Our priorities for the spring session will be obviously the introduction of our budget, which I believe will be a good news budget for Saskatchewan. It will complete the promises that the SAS party made in the last election campaign.
Last year's budget saw a lot of belt tightening across the province. Many sectors were not given enough additional funding to cover the increases in costs from year to year. School divisions and health districts felt the pain of this cut and were told to look internally within the districts to make up this money. When asked if these sectors would face the same challenges this year, Boyd had this to say.
We are in a better position to provide for greater infrastructure in Saskatchewan and a better position to provide for greater services in Saskatchewan, also to look towards paying down debt in our province.
These sectors will have to wait until the budget is officially released on the 23rd of this month to see if there is a little more money in store for them. Another headline-grabbing issue is the much-talked-about upgrades to Mosaic Stadium in Regina. But it seems like after talks in the ledge, these improvements will remain on the drawing board for the time being.
The project isn't going to take place right now. We felt that there had to be funding from three levels of government and from the private sector. Unfortunately, we haven't received any indication from the federal government, so we are putting the project on the back burner.
Boyd adds they're looking at Plan B to develop the stadium, but it won't be considered a priority until more groups come forward with money. The spring sitting in the ledge will continue through until May 19th. And with an election coming up this fall, there could be the potential for more announcements in the coming months. For Southwest TV News, I'm Kara Rapke.